What's up, guys? The new suspense thriller Crawl came out. Does this movie hit or does it flop? Let's find out on today's episode of Planetary Reviews, guys. Guys, what's up everybody? I'm here to review the movie Crawl. Now, going into this movie, I was pretty excited because I heard that Sam Raimi was helping produce this film, and that's something that means a lot because a lot of people know him for the Spider-Man trilogy, but some people might, maybe a good amount of people might know, but there might be some people out there who don't know that Sam Raimi is also responsible for the Evil Dead series, and that series has been just so successful, and there are so many diehard fans out there. So knowing that he is really good with horror, and knowing that he would be at least a part of this film and the production of it, really made me excited. I was really happy for this movie because judging by the trailers, it did look pretty cool. But I was a little nervous that it was gonna fall into the maybe tropey aspect. But you know what? Before we even get started, let's talk about the story. Story of this movie, pretty straightforward. A girl named Haley lives in Florida during this big hurricane, ends up finding out that she doesn't know where her dad is. Her sister tells her, oh, we have to go find her dad. We haven't heard from him for a little bit. So she ends up stopping what she's doing. Instead of getting out and evacuating that section of Florida during this hurricane, she goes back and looks for her dad. And when she finds him, he ends up being inside his home, trapped underneath, with water slowly building up, and all of a sudden you realize, holy crap, there are alligators surrounding this entire house. And throughout the entirety of the movie, you pretty much have that premise. You have this father and daughter trying to make it out of here alive while dealing with water coming into the house. On top of that, gators coming after you. And the amount of stress and the amount of tension throughout this movie could really be felt, and I really love that about this film. But what I really have to commend first and foremost are the performances of these two actors. And the two actors are the one who played the father and the one who played the daughter. And the one who played the daughter, her name is Kaya Sko. Oh my, I'm gonna butcher this last name, and I'm sorry, I'm gonna put it on the screen. But it's Kaya Scodelario, I think I got that right. And then the guy who played the dad was Barry Pepper. They both did an amazing job, and their connection and chemistry could be really felt, which I was not expecting because I didn't know if they were going to be able to give you the tension, suspense, and the action that you would expect, and some good characterization in this movie. I wasn't really sure they were going to be able to pull that off because not many movies have in these types of movies, but luckily they definitely did. And when it comes to the suspense in this movie, while I do feel like it could have been done a little bit better, it was still very, very tense when there were gators surrounding them and they have to deal with these certain situations and they're put into these really tight places, but they have to get out while these gators are coming at them. The movie does a really good job at really building it up a good amount. You're sitting there on the tip of your toes just going, oh man, how's he gonna get out of this? How's he gonna get out of this? And it was just really cool. And the effects for these gators were actually really convincing. They didn't utilize an over amount of CG because if there was an overabundance, it definitely would have killed the movie completely. But because of the fact they're mostly in darkness or in very dirty water, the gators managed to still be scary and still look extremely cool. But I do have to say that I do wish they utilized the gators maybe a little bit less, showed them a little bit less, so you could have the same kind of effect that it had in Jaws when we really barely saw the shark until the very end. But I get it, you want to show the spectacle, you want to show off these cool special effects, but luckily they don't overdo it. But I do think they should have saved the reveal of what they look like and let us actually see them maybe a little bit more into the movie instead of just showing them kind of early, in my opinion. The next thing I gotta say is that the way this movie was shot, very nice. You can tell that there was a lot of good angles, a lot of good just the way the camera movement would go in certain scenes, very nice. The cinematography was really well done. And also, I gotta commend this movie for not taking the easy way out and having tons and tons of jump scares. This movie could have just been jump scares galore, like a lot of horror movies, because a lot of horror movies today end up just trying to jump scare you with, like, silence, 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 and then boom, loud noise, and they try to get you, they jump like that, and that's how they scare you. Luckily, this movie didn't have very much of that. There was only, like, two scenes where that was really a thing, and it wasn't even that annoying. It was actually well-deserved, and it wasn't, like, all throughout the film. Because if stuff like that is always in the movie, it really takes me out of it, because I could call jump scares. Maybe other people can as well, but for me, I know when they're going to happen a lot of time, like, one, two, three, boom, it happens. But man, this movie was actually a really fun movie because it stayed focused also on the story. It didn't try to get too complicated, too crazy. It was just a really simple premise. Hurricane comes in Florida. A daughter and her dad get stuck in a house surrounded by gators, water slowly filling, and they have to handle this and figure out a way to survive and get out. Oh, and another thing, the kills in this movie were very good. I enjoyed them mainly because of the fact that this movie did not sit there and throw all these crazy kills at you and overload you on gore so you become numb to it. No, the movie was actually pretty tame. It got a kill here and there, and it didn't go too crazy. And then another thing I gotta commend that I really liked was that our two protagonists got pretty effed up in this movie. Like, you did not feel like they were these untouchable, like, main characters that nothing's gonna happen to them. No, these guys struggled. These two characters struggled throughout the whole film to make it through this. And they got the wounds and everything to show it. And it was just a really nice way to portray the struggle and the humanity of these characters by showing them getting hurt, and that's always a plus for me. Showing your protagonist getting hurt and that they are not superheroes in a horror movie like this is always a plus for me. But one thing I do have to say is that it doesn't do anything groundbreaking. It does the suspense thriller aspect well. It just doesn't do anything that makes you go, wow, this is the greatest thing ever. No, it doesn't do anything that's going to revolutionize the way we see a suspense movie or a thriller ever. It doesn't do anything like that. But what this movie does do is that it does make you feel the tension. It does make you feel the character development, believe it or not, between these two characters when they're interacting and their relationship develops throughout the film, and you really do enjoy it. And it's just overall a fun ride. I had a good time. The only time I really felt out of it was like the first 10-15 minutes or so when they were just trying to give us a story and stuff. I didn't really feel compelled by that storyline. But once we get into the big stuff, once we get into the big scenario of what's going on, the movie really does propel. So at the end of the day, guys, in my opinion, Crawl gets a very solid B+ from me, guys. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you guys saw this movie in the comment section below, because I was really surprised. I walked out of this movie very happy and like, wow, that was cool. That was a fun experience. It wasn't anything like, wow, but it was something that was entertaining, and it got the tense going, got your blood pumping a little bit. And that's exactly what I was expecting from a movie like this with the way the trailers were. And I'm very happy to say that I walked out of this with two thumbs up. I was like, hell yeah, that was cool. But guys, like I said, let me know what you thought of this movie in the comment section below. Do you think it was good? Do you think it was bad? You know, it's all up to, at the end of the day, if you get scared easily, maybe you'll get scared of this movie. But one thing that I've just given up on with horror movies is that I just don't get scared anymore. They just don't scare me. So this movie, in my opinion, if you're going in there also for the horror aspect, how scared are you going to be? I can't tell you if this movie is scary. I just think that the movie is very tense and very suspense-filled. So, if you're going in there trying to get scared, I honestly can't tell you whether it is or not, because I didn't get scared. I was just entertained. But I could ramble on for hours. But guys, thank you so much for watching, and have a great day, guys.